My name is Cheryl Sandall, Dean of the School of Nursing. I am excited for you to see our new simulation spaces today that were made possible by a generous grant from the Manitou Fund. I would like to introduce Joanne Tingham, our simulation director. In her role as simulation director, Joanne coordinates all activities within our skills and simulation spaces, and she works with faculty on how best to use simulation as a teaching strategy.
All right, thank you, Dr. Sandall, and I'm excited to share the new space with you all today. We're going to look at two different types of rooms. One is meant to replicate an ambulatory care setting, so more of the clinic where a patient might be seen, while the other one is an acute care setting, so students can learn about caring for a patient in a hospital. This is one of our ambulatory care rooms. In this type of setting, our nurse practitioner and undergraduate nursing students will get to experience simulations that may include caring for patients across the lifespan. For instance, they may care for an expecting mother, a newborn, a child, either for a well child exam or experiencing some type of symptoms, all the way through our elderly patients. In this simulation, a student is seeing a patient who's come in for an annual exam. The student can do anything from listen to her heart lung sounds, complete a head to toe assessment, as well as ask questions. While the student interviews the patient, the simulation operations specialist in the control room is able to interact with any questions that are being asked, playing the voice of the patient or the mannequin in this situation, as well as manipulate heart sounds, lung sounds, vital signs, and so on. It makes for a truly interactive and immersive experience. In addition to mannequin-based simulation, we also use standardized patients in simulation. Standardized patients are actors trained with a specific set of symptoms that present to the clinic, the hospital, or other setting, providing a more realistic form of simulation. This is one of our acute care simulation rooms. This room has currently been transformed to offer a home care setting. Graduate and undergraduate nursing students will be able to experience care of a patient in their home. This is one of our acute care simulation rooms. This is a larger room which really provides students the opportunity to practice dynamic team-based simulations, whether it be a resuscitation, a trauma, or something as simple as the first time hanging antibiotics. Students really get to experience what it's like being the nurse in those situations. We're able to focus on high-risk, low-volume situations. For instance, not every student gets to experience a resuscitation during their clinical, but we can ensure every student has the opportunity to experience resuscitation, practice, and learn in the simulation lab. This is our graduate nursing skills lab. Nurse practitioner students will learn any number of skills in this room. They may learn how to suture, splinting, or advance head-to-toe assessment for the nurse practitioner. This is our acute care skills space. In this space, students will start with skills such as learning how to do proper hand washing, donning and doffing, personal protective equipment, as well as more advanced skills such as injections, IV starts, wound care, or administering blood products. Our goal is to provide our students with two additional skill spaces. One of them would replicate the acute skills lab that you saw, while the other one would be a hybrid option that would serve both graduate and undergraduate students.
Thank you, Joanne. I hope that the spaces you've seen today have gotten you excited about nursing education at the College of St. Scholastica. Simulation is an integral part of a nursing student's education. Through simulation, nursing students get the opportunity to practice thinking like a nurse. It makes all the difference.